Hey guys, I wanted to answer a question I get asked quite often, which is it spiritual to suffer? And it's pretty common thought, and I get asked this very often. So I just wanted to give you my thoughts on it. So I believe that we should absolutely have no tolerance for suffering whatsoever. Every time we have suffering in our lives, it's a signal, it's something is out of alignment. Something is not right. Now, I'm not talking about like when things outside of you happen, like, you know, maybe someone you love dies. That's a different kind of suffering. But when you are going day to day in your life and you're suffering because you hate your job, or you're suffering because you're not getting along with your family members, or you're suffering because, you know, financial reasons or whatever. When you look at those things, a lot of times people think, I hear this quite frequently, of God is testing me. And I just need to embrace the suffering. Suffering is part of religion. It's part of spirituality. It's part of growth. And I think that's hogwash. And I think we should take every sign of suffering as an alert. Like I talk about all the time, those dummy signs that come on in your car, suffering is a dummy sign that something is out of alignment. So if you are at your job and you hate your job, there is something inside of you trying to tell you something is not right. You're out of alignment somewhere, whether it's your thoughts or the actual job or people around you and the way you respond to people around you, something is out of alignment. So anytime you suffer, you've got to stop. Like every single emotion, suffering is an emotion. It's something where you have to stop. It's an alert. It's telling you that something is out of alignment. There should be no tolerance whatsoever for suffering. And I hear so many people say, oh, it's just part of the process and I just need to embrace my suffering. And then they end up pushing down that intuition. They're pushing down the thing inside of them that's trying to tell them that something is out of alignment. They're not listening to that internal guide coming from the source of all creation, from the source of everything. They're ignoring that internal guide, and then they ignore it, and they ignore it, and they ignore it, and then they can't hear it anymore. And they think this is just how life is. And then they live their whole life that way, thinking this is just life. And then you ask them, how are you? I'm fine. You know, and then they're waiting for retirement so they can have some fun and then die. And life is just not meant to be that way. Every emotion that you have, everything that doesn't spark joy and excitement is something that's trying to tell you something. And even the excitement is trying to tell you something. Emotions are telling you something. Don't tolerate your emotions. They're telling you something. If it's exciting, it's telling you move forward. If it's awful and it's suffering, it's telling you something is wrong. Let's stop tolerating our emotions and start embracing the fact that they are our teachers, and they are teaching us that something isn't right. Something is right. They're teaching you something. Stop and listen. It's like if your gas tank was almost empty and you decided to put a sticker over it so that you couldn't see that it was running low. That's not going to do you any good. Your car is still going to run out of gas. And if we put these stickers, you know, it's almost like these masks we put over our face and we just say, everything's fine, everything's fine. And, you know, I hear this so often. People just push their emotions down because they don't want to deal with them, because they don't know what they mean, because they think they're not supposed to feel that way. There is no emotion you're not supposed to feel. Every emotion that comes up for you is teaching you something. Embrace it. I'm even talking about anger, the emotion everybody's terrified of. And it's not anger that you're terrified of. It's sometimes people act out in anger and hurt other people. That's completely different. Some people act out in depression and hurt other people. So don't be afraid of your emotions. And when other people are around you and they're trying to push away your emotions because it makes them uncomfortable, that's not your problem. I'm here to tell you today that is not your problem. If other people are uncomfortable with your emotions, that's their own problem and their own stuff they need to deal with. And a lot of times people will get to where they finally feel anger about stuff, which is important. You gotta feel angry when things aren't right, because that, how do you know how to change? How do you know how to get out of circumstances? How do you know how you're supposed to be guided in your life if you ignore your emotions? But other people are afraid of anger. This is just the common one that people are afraid of. The people around you get afraid that you're angry, and they would rather you go back into depression than be angry about something. Because at least with depression, it's pointed inward, and often anger can be pointed outward. I'm here to tell you today, love yourself enough to get angry. Love yourself enough to follow your excitement. Love yourself enough to listen to every single emotion that comes up for you as a teacher. It's teaching you something. Listen to it. So that's why I want to encourage you today is to not tolerate any emotions, but listen to them as teachers. I hope that helps somebody.